everyone. My name is Justin Newman. Today I'm going to be going over modular exponentiation with the Chinese Remainder Theorem.
Let's begin. So we can start with a couple larger numbers, like 762 to the 121st power, divided by 99. First thing we want to do is go ahead and establish our formulas, which is going to be x bar equals the sum from k, or from 1 to k, of the terms a sub I times z sub I. Finally, we mod by m, m being the number we're modding by 99. So to find ai, or a sub I, we use c to t. Modded by an I, z sub I equals m sub I times y sub I, where m sub I is equal to m over n I, and y I is equal to the inverse mod of m sub I. Okay, and then we can go ahead and establish our n values, which are going to be two relative pairwise primes to get 99, which is going to be n1 equals 9 and n2 equals 11. So this should work with the GCD of these two numbers is equal to 1, which it is. So now we can go ahead and find the binary representation of the exponent. So we just have to get the binary representation of 121, which is going to be as simple as using the 4 of 121 over 2, which will give us 60 remainder 1, and then 60 remainder 2. You guys get the remainders here, that's the most important part for getting the binary of this. So 30 over 2, floor that, and 15, r equals 0. Okay, so here's all the significant bit, so we can rewrite this as binary. Okay. Done that, we're going to want to find A. So to get A1, I like to use this process. Let's see. So now we use our binary. So this table with the binary bits, and then use your base for your exponent here, and then step one of this algorithm, which is called square and multiply. Take your base, square it, 1 by 9. Now so now we're going to use the calculator. So we're going to do center squared. Divided by 9, 0 times same process here, but instead of using mod 1, I'm using mod 11, since 11 is n sub 2.
If you're in the position of a 1 as the bin. So we're going to get 6,858. Turns out you get 2,286. Computed our values for A, we're going to want to go ahead and compute Z sub I. So we just need to find out for what I is, which is just going to be our values for M sub I. M sub I is pretty easy to find. You just plug in here 99 over 9, the 11, 99 over 11 for M2, if I'm mistaken, then you get 9. Okay, that makes sense. So now we just do M sub I inverse mod, so it would be 11 inverse mod 9. To do this, we just use this table. And since this number is greater than 9, you want to subtract 9 from this number until it's less than 9. So you're just going to end up with 9 and 2. 2 goes into that 9 4 times, the remainder of 1. And then 2
your column for t, you would use this value minus this value times this value, which is just the older t minus old t times q, which in this case gives you negative 4. Now since negative 4 mod 9, then you get 5. Now for y2, let's do this. And now you can just use 11 and 9. So 9 goes into that once, negative 2. Okay, so now we can compute our value for z, which is just going to be 11 times y1, which is 5, which is 55, z2, 9 times 5, which equals. So now in the last step, find the answer. We're just going to do AI, so 0 times C155, which is going to go 0 plus 762 times 45. And then lastly, we just multiply by M, which is 99. So now we just have to do 762 times 45. And then mod by 99. Should give us 36.